This video is brought to you by mywayteaching.com.
Dear students, till now we studied about the thermodynamics, electrodynamics, mechanics and electrodynamics part. So now let us see what we are going to study in optics, thermodynamics. Okay. So in optics, that is one of the subcategory of physics. So in that we are going to study the working of optical fiber, telescopes, microscopes, imagers formed by the lenses and mirrors. Okay. In this optical fiber is mainly used for the purpose of communication, isn't it? So in this figure we can see this is an optical fiber. So this optical fiber, properties of this optical fiber, how it is better compared to traditional methods, and even the telescopes, about the lenses, the quality of the images formed by the lenses, about all these things we are going to study in optics. Okay. Similarly, in thermodynamics, we are going to study about the internal energy, temperature and entropy of the system. So, thermodynamics means basically we are going to study about the heat, the applications of heat, properties of heat, okay, about the things which are related to heat. So about that one we are going to study in thermodynamics. And not only this, the thermodynamics also deals with, as I told you, about internal energy, temperature, entropy, so all those things. And this entropy is the amount of energy that is unavailable to do any useful work. Okay. So, in thermodynamics, it deals with all these things. Along with this, we are going to study about the efficiency of heat engines. Okay, this is one of the important concepts in thermodynamics. So, performance of heat engines, applications of heat engines, different types of heat engines. So, efficiency of heat engines and what is this heat engines, why it is used. About all these things we are going to study in thermodynamics. Okay. So, till now we studied about the scope of physics, isn't it? So, this scope of physics, as we can see from the examples that I have given, it is just infinite. Because in physics, we not only study in atomic level or molecular level, we study even about galaxies. You know, in physics, we study about galaxies and even about the structure of galaxies. We study about galaxies and their structure and even the large distance of the order of billion light years among them, and what is the mechanism, okay, that takes place inside the galaxies, inside the sun, distribution of billions of kilograms of their matter. You know, galaxies, they have huge matter, isn't it? How it is distributed. So, even not only this, we will study about birth, death and evolution of stars, okay. About all these things, we are going to study under the branch called as physics, okay. Here we can see The scope of physics, if we consider in terms of length, it varies from 10 raised to minus 14 to 10 raised to 40. So this 10 raised to minus 40, do you know what it represents? This 10 raised to minus 14 is just the radius of nucleus. So the scope of physics varies from radius of nucleus to 10 raised to 40. This 10 raised to 40 is a length of galaxy. That's why I told you the scope of physics is infinite. It varies from vacuum to infinity. Okay, this is length of galaxies. So the scope of physics, it varies from 10 raised to minus 14 to 10 raised to plus 40. And if we take consider in time scale, then the scope of physics, it varies from 10 raised to minus 22 seconds to 10 raised to 18 seconds. Okay, on the time scale, it varies from 10 raised to minus 14 to 10 raised to plus 18 seconds. And if we consider in terms of mass, okay, if we consider on a mass scale, then the scope of physics varies from 10 raised to minus 30 kg to 10 raised to 55 kg, okay. And this 10 raised to minus 30 kg, it represents mass of an electron, and this 10 raised to 55 kg, it represents mass of observable universe. So it varies, the scope of physics varies from the smallest part, that is atom, to the largest one, that is galaxy. Okay. And this, we can also say that the scope of physics varies between two interesting domains, okay, which means that is the two interesting domains, which means macroscopic as well as microscopic, macroscopic to microscopic. So in this macroscopic, one example we can give is galaxy, isn't it? I told you it is a macroscopic part. In microscopic, we can consider atoms, molecules, isn't it? So the scope of physics, it varies from microscopic to macroscopic. So the scope of physics is very large. So now we are going to study what is hypothesis, axioms and models. Do you have any idea what is this hypothesis, axioms and models? Okay, I'll explain it for you. See, hypothesis is a supposition without assuming that it is true, which means hypothesis is nothing but assumption. You're getting my point, right? Yes. In hypothesis, we have to assume few things. If you assume that thing means, then only we can prove all the other laws or other theories or the concepts which are explained based on that law. For example, no one can prove universal law of gravitation. Okay, as Newton says, every object on the universe attracts every other object on the universe. Okay, he said that. But no one can prove it. But we can verify it through various experiments by conducting experiments on that, we can verify it, we can test that law, but we can't prove it. It is just an assumption. If you assume that the two bodies on the universe attracts each other because of gravitational force, and that gravitational force is directly proportional to masses of the two bodies, and it is inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So if you assume this, then only we can prove all the concepts which are based on this, like acceleration due to gravity, finding the gravitational constant in a depth of h and in a height of h. So various other theories which are related to this gravitation can be proved only if you assume this. But this gravitational law is having, it doesn't have any proof. It is only an assumption. But if I say an axiom, then this axiom is a self-evident truth. So as the sentence itself says, the axiom are having proofs, okay? They are not assumptions, but they are proved theorems, okay? Axioms are not just assumptions, they have a proof, okay? We can prove these axioms. If they are proved, then only we can accept them as axioms, okay? One simple example I will give you. If I say A and B are the two real numbers, so if I say A and B are the two real numbers, then the product or the summation, let us take summation of two real numbers, gives a number C, which is again a real number, isn't it? Can we prove this? If A and 2 are the if A and B are the two real numbers, then the number, the summation, after doing the summation of two real numbers, that is A plus B, will get another number C, isn't it? And that also belongs to the category of real number, isn't it? And we can prove it mathematically also. So this we can consider as an axiom because it is having some proof. So this axioms are the self-evident truth. And even in the maths, we have so many axioms, isn't it? You will study all those things in maths also. Whereas hypothesis is just an assumption. Coming to the one more important part, that is model. This model is a theory proposed to explain the observed phenomena. So if there is any natural phenomena that is taking place in our surrounding places, okay, after doing so many experiments and after studying about that, after doing research, we'll end up with result. So now we'll consider, we'll do some, you know, the models which can explain what we have observed, isn't it? So it is just another way we can say model is just the application of theory. Application of the things that we have studied whenever we see any natural event. Okay, whenever we study any natural event, so in order to explain the theory behind that, in order to explain the concept behind that, we consider the models, isn't it? Then only we can understand, okay, then only we can convey the idea to others. So that is nothing but model. It is just a theory which is proposed to explain the observed phenomena. In other words, it is just the application of theory. So how that natural phenomena how that natural phenomena that we study is what we can say, we can how it can be explained. So that can be explained with the consideration of these models. Okay, the theory we'll put it in a form of model so that we can convey the concepts very easily. So these three are the very important points. So in the next class again, we are going to study about the physics, technology and society.